One of the most common tasks undertaken in text mining analyses is topic detection, sometimes called topic modeling. Given an input text, topic detection tries to determine its subject, perhaps based on a particular comment, conversation, or even forum post. Like many data analytics tasks, topic detection can be used in either an unsupervised or supervised manner. In this video, though, we'll consider a common method for the unsupervised approach: latent Dirichlet allocation, also known as LDA. LDA is a generative algorithm that sets out to detect the top K topics in a dataset as described by the most relevant N keywords, where values of K and N are user-supplied parameters. Put another way, the documents in the dataset are represented as random mixtures of latent topics, where each topic is characterized by a Dirichlet distribution over a fixed vocabulary. Here, latent means the topics must be inferred or interpreted based on their constituent terms, rather than directly observed. For this algorithm, we also make certain assumptions about our documents. For example, we assume that neither order of documents in the corpus nor order of words in each document is important. Also, we allow that the same word can belong to multiple topics, and the number of topics is known in advance. When the algorithm finishes execution, it provides as output a weighted representation of terms and topics, along with an assignment of one of the topics to each document. Let's see how LDA can be applied in KNIME. In this simplified workflow, I've read in a series of posts from the KNIME forum. I've also pre-processed the data to apply the required stemming, filtering, and so on using these components. To perform topic extraction in KNIME Analytics Platform, we can use the Topic Extractor Parallel LDA node shown here. Let's see what it can tell us about topics being discussed on the KNIME forum. In the node's configuration, we see that we must provide a document column for processing. We also have a seed field where we can provide a static integer for reproducibility. Below that, we must supply our number of topics, K, and the number of words associated with each topic. In this case, I've chosen a K of 5, and an N of 10. The alpha parameter governs the Dirichlet prior on the per document topic distribution, while the beta parameter defines the prior on the per topic multinomial distribution over words. Basically, smaller values for these parameters prefer fewer topics or words per document. We can also set the number of iterations and threads available to the algorithm to have an effect on performance. After execution, we can see three different output ports available from the node. The first is a document table with different topic probabilities. Each document in our dataset appears on its own row, along with the corresponding topic probabilities that the LDA algorithm has calculated for each of our five topics. The largest of the probabilities determines the topic assignment in the far right column. But what do these topics actually represent? For this, we can look at the second output port from this node, which contains a weighted list of the terms, in our case, 10 for each topic. I can see that this topic contains terms like KNIME, node, error, and workflow, so I might infer that this topic has to do with problems forum users encounter when running their workflows. This other topic, meanwhile, contains terms like node, column, row, and value, so I might infer that this topic deals instead with tabular data structures. Note that the weights provided here are relevant within topics, not necessarily between them. Also, as expected, we sometimes see the same word associated with different topics. The terms are not mutually exclusive. Finally, the third output port, iteration statistics, gives us an indication of how the model approached convergence. While the output from the Topic Extractor Parallel LDA node is useful on its own, I can also send it downstream to a tag cloud and a bar chart for a visual representation of the topics and associated terms found in my document set. In this component, I've done just that. The tag cloud plots the different terms identified, where the color corresponds to topics, and the size represents the relative weights. The bar chart, meanwhile, is a simple plot of the count of the documents by topic. Here we can see that though the algorithm has identified five different topics, most of the documents only are associated with two of them. In this video, we've discussed briefly one of the most popular topic detection algorithms, LDA, and how you can apply and interpret its results with KNIME Analytics Platform. As with most unsupervised modeling approaches, there's a bit of art to go with the science. In this case, determining the number of topics and associated words may require some finesse to be able to understand what's being discussed in your dataset. Give the LDA algorithm a try and see what you can discover.